We are very excited as it all starts to filter in. We think about another name that Lotz had highlighted in the longest email in the history of emails, Marcus Johansson, to Boston. You had him highlighted and you went over his value, Lotz. How about this fit and the cost for the Bruins?
He's a top six forward, and Boston is a team that I think is a great fit for him because they've got the structure that can keep Marcus Johansson on point. He can drift a little bit, maybe defensively at times, but the fact of the matter is that he's got a skill set that the Boston Bruins can use. He's going to be a nice addition with them in their group. I'm just dying to find out right what the cost was. We had it as it was probably going to be a second, possibly a third, depending on if there's any retained salary in it. And I felt like for a guy with this cap hit, you might have to retain a little bit of salary to pull more people into the fight in order to get a move for what you want. We'll find out about that very shortly.
Makes me wonder this now. I like the addition of Johansson. I think he's a very solid player.
He can play with and crazy. Play,
absolutely. Yeah. But now does he play the wing? He's going to have to play the wing because now you got Charlie Coyle as your third line center, which was something that they were trying to address. Yep. Charlie Coyle will be a full-time center iceman now.
Don't you think?
Yeah, that makes the most sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes, when we were looking at it earlier with that Bees lineup. So I thought the Bees might have been a little bit more aggressive because they do have prospects, but nonetheless, I like the Bees. I like their team, especially when everybody's healthy. I think Johansson's a nice, solid add for them.
And especially the way he's playing, 12 points in his last 13 games. I'm coming back at you with Charlie Coyle at the center position. Scott Stevens, when he coached with the Minnesota Wild, pointed out he can play wing, he can play center. I'd rather have him in the center, Scott, he said, if he's going to produce either way, because your centerman is so much more involved. Is that why you like seeing Coyle down the middle?
It is, but also his size, his ability to skate. He can pass the puck forehand, backhand. He can make plays. And I think he's more skilled. The thing with Charlie Coyle now, what I'm curious to see, is going back home to Beantown and playing in Beantown. Mm-hmm. Is he going to have the foam in the mouth every game? Is every game going to be like he's playing not only in the bean pot, but for the Bees? Yeah. That's what I want to see because he certainly has a skill lot. So you do him well.
Yeah, he does, and that's been the rap against him a little bit. He didn't have that grit on a nice nightly basis. He's a big man. Mm-hmm. He is a very powerful guy. I like him personally in the middle on the third line more than I do, say, on the second line on the wing. And I say that because I'm not sure the hockey IQ can always keep up with those elite top six players, where I do think he's excellent defensively. I think he takes pride in it. It forces him to use his body more. Those are strengths of him. It simplifies the game. I think that we're going to see him probably bounce around a little bit, depending on injuries with the Bruins, until he finally settles into that role.
Let's bounce over to the rink. Dan Rosen, you've got more on Johansson and the Bruins, some history there.
Yeah, just a little aside here, guys. It's going to be an interesting first conversation between Marcus Johansson and Brad Marchand if this trade goes through. If you remember a year ago, last year, Brad Marchand was suspended for 5 games for elbowing Marcus Johansson, concussed him. And if you remember after that, a while after that, Marcus Johansson's remarks were, it was stupid. And that it's a shame that there are guys still out there trying to hurt other players in the league. So just as a little aside, there's a lot of forgive and forget in this league. And I know there is, but there's also grudges. And it will be an interesting first conversation. I wish both of them would be mic'd up. If Marcus Johansson ends up in Boston and they gets that conversation with Brad Marchand.